Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, Sean Locke, John Richardson, Terry Ad Lloyd, Rob Beckett, Jamie Lang, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, the word nebbish used to mean someone timid, meek and ineffectual? Basically, it's an old-fashioned word for John Richardson. In the Farsi language, the term tiam describes the sparkle in someone's eyes when you meet them for the first time. For me, it's a sparkle I most often see in the glint of my headlights in the lay-by off the westbound A42 outside Hemel Hempstead on Thursday nights. And the average dog can understand over 150 words. Unfortunately, five of them aren't "don't shit on my driveway". Right, let's get started. Okay, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. John got married recently, so sorry, ladies, but one of you had to make the ultimate sacrifice.
Joke's on you, mate, because you said A42 outside Hemel Hempstead, and the A42 doesn't go near Hemel Hempstead. I think you'll find the A42 connects the M42 to Nottingham, so good luck when this goes out, mate. You're going to get absolutely owned.
And John's teammate, it's Carrie Ad Lloyd. Carrie Ad plays Megan in the sitcom Peep Show. In Peep Show, you can hear the character's thoughts. I'm glad that doesn't happen on this show. I really should have taken out those anal beads before we started. Up against them this evening is Sean Locke. Sean started his professional life as a labourer, but that hasn't held him back. What's held him back is his looks and personality. And joining Sean tonight is Rob Beckett. Rob started brushing his teeth 9 years ago, and great news...
The setup. He doesn't even need the punchline.
Rob started brushing his teeth 9 years ago, and great news, he's nearly finished. Okay, Rob, where do your strengths lie? I mean, you're not great with the letters or the numbers. Where do your strengths lie?
I'm good at cutting out.
Keeps me busy. Heard that expression, like...
Well, cut it out. Don't you cut out?
No, just... Not what? Since, like, I was five.
Well, how'd you do your Christmas list about cutting out the Argos catalogue? Bit of cutting out, innit? I like it. It chills me out. I did three hours on a tree frog the other day. You seen the fingers on a tree frog?
Yeah, it must be really quite a challenge, I mean.
3 hours, mate. The elbows are doing angles I've never seen before.
Do you go straight for sort of the intense work, or do you sort of loosely cut around?
So I loosely cut around the whole piece.
Yeah.
Then maybe do right hand. Do they have hands, frogs?
Yeah.
What, is it a frog hand?
Yeah.
Don't sound right, does it?
Not a paw.
No.
Nothing sounds great the way you say it.
It's a foot, isn't it?
They
have 2 feet. So it's a foot.
They have four legs.
The dog's got 4 feet.
Yeah, frog foot. Do you know what I found out the other day? We only eat lady chickens.
Is that a religious thing in your family?
No, all people that eat chickens, it's all lady chickens.
What do you think happens to the boy chicks?
They're cockerels, but they don't have as many because lady chicken hens, whatever you want to call them, they grow quicker, bigger quicker, so people eat lady chickens and not male ones. But that blew my mind.
That's why they call it Nando's, not Grandad does.
OK, Sean, here's a question for you. If you had to flee Britain, which country would best suit your temperament?
I've always wanted to... I've always thought about India. I found India quite exciting, the idea of India. It's a country where you can get killed by a tiger or a salad. That would be very thrilling. But anywhere you can use a 3-pin plug. I'm happy.
Jersey.
No, not definitely not Jersey.
Oh, yeah, I'm not. Have you been Jersey?
Mm.
Strange, isn't it?
I've been to Jersey.
OK, Carrie-Ad, you're on John's team today. How do you think you'll work as a teammate?
Well, I think we'll be OK. We're both small, dark and hairy.
Thank you for sharing.
So I feel like it's like two lovely hobbits playing with words. Or like a budget, like Lidl version of Brad and Angelina. Yeah?
I'm hearing a lot of words, Carrie-Ad. I'm hearing the words hobbit, Lidl.
We'd be lovely hobbits. Come
it's
on, look
not
at
what
you.
I'm aiming
You'd
for.
Be such a good hobbit.
It's my 112nd birthday today. I didn't want to say anything.
John, it's Carrie-Ad's first time on Countdown. Have you got any advice for her? You know we can still see you, John.
No. It's funny, cos when I put this on, I disappeared in my fucking house. I don't mean that. She's the first woman that showed me any affection, and let me just say that that was just a joke, and please don't be gone when I get home.
OK, John, Carrie-Ad's first time on the show. How are you going to advise her this evening? What would you advise her to do?
I would say drop the hobbit shit. Ruin my self-esteem. Countdown's just a game, and we're playing Rob, so it'll probably be all right.
Who won last time, Mouth?
I didn't understand a word of that.
I won last time. I'm on a hot run of form.
Are you asking me or your own mouth?
I'll ask you my own mouth.
Who won last time, Mouth?
Who was I playing
Cheers,
with?
Mouth.
Did you hear him, Miz?
Oh, yeah, we heard him. Don't you worry.
So, have you just reminded Rob he was on John's team when they won last time?
Yeah, I think.
I was on your team, wasn't I?
Yeah, we did.
Yeah,
nice.
Fair enough. I say we, I reckon it was 80-20 you.
I'm frankly amazed 80-20 added up to 100. John, have you got a mascot this evening?
It's more of a sort of pitch, Jimmy, to be honest.
A pitch? Love a pitch.
Well, this
I'm all ears.
This started as a one-off, didn't it? Catch This Countdown. It's a bit of a laugh. So I've decided that we can obviously do other shows. So through the show tonight, I'm going to pitch a few new ideas. So I'm starting with 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown Does Great British Bake Off.
OK, and sorry, you're saying to Carrie-Ad, don't continue with the Hobbit thing. That's what you're saying, though, is it? Yeah? Don't continue with the Hobbit thing.
Kefir Master Richardson.
It looks small to you, but to him...
is a real oven.
Ooh.
So I've baked us all a cake. Jamie, this is for you. This is a made-in-Chelsea bun. It's very similar to an ordinary Chelsea bun, but I've put too much sugar in it, so it's unbearably rich.
Thank you.
Aren't you related to biscuits in some way?
My great-great-grandfather invented the digestive.
And the Jaffa cake.
And the not the Jaffa cake, the rich tea.
Oh, the rich tea?
Yeah.
You've done Jaffas.
I don't know who did Jaffa cake.
It's big tea.
Yeah, that's your family, you know that. You should know this.
I don't know. Does anyone know their family history? I don't really know.
What, your family history?
I don't know who in my family invented a biscuit. Unless Uncle Jammy Dodger.
I know something else in your oven there. What else have you got?
Oh, yes, James. this is for you. This is an iced fing car.
An iced fing car?
Yes, because you're Jimmy Carr. It looks like an ordinary ice finger, but I've had the icing artificially whitened.
Carrie-Ad, do you have a mascot?
Yeah, I do.
What have you got?
Well, I did a 53-hour marathon, improv marathon. We improvised non-stop for 53 hours.
And why did you do that? What's the opposite of public demand?
And one of the guys in the marathon dressed up as this character who I want to talk about now. This is David Bowie from The Labyrinth Years. one of the guys dressed up as this during the marathon, and because I didn't sleep for 53 hours, I thought he was David Bowie. And in the show, I got married to him, so for about 25 hours, I thought I was married to David Bowie from the Labyrinth. so we're good.
I love it. Rob, have you got a mascot?
Yes, mate. I've brought some of my favourite figures as a kid. In my little box. These were my favourite figures growing up, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put down my favourite football team out of all my figures. So what I normally start my team... if you need a good defender, didn't you? Sol Campbell. He's good, isn't he? And I know what you're thinking. What's better than one Sol Campbell in your team? Two Sol Campbells. you need a goalkeeper in a good team, didn't you? I haven't got any goalkeepers. Next best thing, Andre the Giant. Look at that hand. He's stopping everything. Need some defence on the right back and left back. I need some protection. What kind of protection do I need? Proper protection. Big boss man in the Mountie. They'll look after everyone.
Who is Big Boss Man?
They're wrestlers.
Right.
Right, so I need some midfielder. I need some steel. I need the governor in midfield. Paul Ince. What's better than one Paul Ince? Two Paul Inces. Eric Cantona up front. What's better than Eric Cantona? Two Alan Shearers. And then on the wing, he'll lay down for a bit. On the wing. He's not doing good. Oh, I'll have Noel Edmonds in instead. He knows what he's doing. On the wing, I've got my favourite wrestler of all time, Coco Beware. He's got a parrot called Frankie. You've got him on the wing, it's a parrot, right? And now you know what you're thinking. I need someone on the far right, don't I? Hulk Hogan. Mainly political views, and probably best to keep him as far away from Coco as possible, so... that's my team.
Sean, do you have a mascot?
Well, Jimmy, I have. I've decided to make, if you'd like to help me, Fabio, bring on my countdown cocktail I'm going to make, which is a cocktail made from drinks from every letter of the alphabet. Thank you, there.
I mean, if this is genuine booze, we're already in a lot of trouble.
So here we go. And I've got, a special glass for it to be in. Making of the countdown cocktail. I've obviously tried it. It's delicious. We start with some, just as a base drink, just a bit of amaretto. That's like that. That's A.
That's a
for amaretto.
Fine base, yeah, lovely. A.
And then there's some umbongo.
That's beautifully poured there. Yeah. That's something from cocktail.
C, cheeky half. Dr. Pepper, lovely. Balances the flavours. What's on every cocktail these days? Espresso. And then some vodka. just a little.
Yeah, vodka.
Then there's the guest ale.
Oh, not the whole thing, interesting.
God, no, no. And then half. And then, of course, what do you need for every cocktail? You need some ice, don't you? One, two. Hey, it's party time. Three. Chin.
Chin, did you say?
Pardon, what did you say?
What was that?
Chin.
Chin.
Then, of course, K is Kiora.
Has that been watered down at all, or is that neat?
That's neat.
Oh, is that double concentrate we're looking at?
Oh, sure. Oh, how easy.
I'm not drinking the toilet cleaner. God, just about take off the edge off the gin. OK, so what do you have after K? A very, very fine drink, Liebfrau Milch, which is the milk of a loved woman. There we go. We got right to M. Mead.
Oh, I like it.
You'll like that, actually. You should try some of that. And then N is Nog without the egg.
Oh. That's curdled it up real nice, that.
N, what's next? O, Ouzo. I only put this in to help the Greek economy. P, lovely bit of pesto.
And how much do you put in just one finger's worth?
Yeah, just a finger flick.
Just a pinch.
Q's Cointreau.
Delicious.
This would be an ideal drink to have if you're just meeting up with a couple of friends and going to the theatre or the cinema. You'd have one of these.
Nothing too fussy.
Before, if you were going to see a sort of like a drama, Shakespeare play or something like that, and you wanted something just to sort of like take the edge off the day. Ah, rest of the bottle. Anything you got knocking around at home, whatever it is.
That's why it's always different. That's the fun. That's half the fun.
S, champagne. There we go. Tea, some tea. Not too much tea. Can really kill a good cocktail with tea. V, Vimto. Again, creates a lot of balance.
And colour don't change, does it?
W, I think no cocktail, no alpha, no countdown cocktails satisfied without a couple of whelks in it. X is X. And that is very close to being made. And we just have one last ingredient here, which is really healthy, is the Yakult. Oh. Finally, zest of lemon. But not too much. You don't want to overpower the flavour. There we go.
A bit of lime. Lime.
Okay. Lime. Sorry, best zest of lime. Oh, the whole thing's wasted. Oh, forget it. Move on. No, I forgot to put the U, umbrella. Then you just have a straw.
Oh, mate.
Oh. There's two whelks in there.
It could do with a little bit more tea.
I kind of want to try it.
Did you like to try it? Just yeah, try some. I've got some straws here. Please do.
You need a knife and fork.
Spirit. Would you like to try a little sip? What do you think?
I've had worse.
It's quite
fruity.
Well, we could do this romantic thing where we drink it together. 3 Mile Island iced tea.
No, what a bit of
you got a bit of whelk.
You mess with whelk.
Oh, you got whelk through a straw?
Here you are.
So how large you
with every it? Cocktail, you get a towel.
Yeah, just less egg next time.
Okay.
A bit more Kiora.
Would anyone like some?
Oh, yeah.
Put a whelk in there.
Yeah,
well.
Put a whelk in.
No, I'll put it there on the side.
Just, if any of that goes on me, this is over.
This is like your worst nightmare, this, isn't it, John?
End of that whelk looks like an anus that's been done up on time to.
He's just retired from the porn industry.
Sean's cocktail, everyone. OK, I'm from Dictionary Corner. It's from Made in Chelsea, Jamie Lang. Jamie is a playboy and heir to the McVitie's biscuit fortune. He's described himself as a cross between Hugh Hefner and Willy Wonka. Fair enough. I've heard a few people describe him as a huge wonker. Jamie, do posh people watch Countdown?
I think so. Yeah, yeah.
Have you ever seen the show?
I've seen the show, yeah. But I'm not very good at spelling or maths. So I kind of just... you just watch it, right?
OK. And with Jamie, of course, is Susie Dent. Susie, you recently researched different words for testicles for a charity campaign. What were your favourites?
So I don't know what you call yours. You can tell us later, but, I mean, on the show.
I know what I call mine. Huey, Louie and Dewey.
Anyway, I put together this little thesaurus of testicles, because if you go back in the past, there have been hundreds of names for them. So there's jelly bags, Aunt Polly's...
Oh, sorry, jelly bags?
Jelly bags, Aunt Polly's.
Aunt Polly's?
Ging-ma-bobs, twiddle-diddles.
I love this. Susie once asked me what the origin of tea bagging was, why it was called tea bagging.
I think it was that drink.
This conversation all the time, not that particular one, but
it's probably best if I demonstrate. Okay, in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley.
Rachel hosted a TV show called Memory Slam, which somewhat ironically, everyone forgot to watch. when was that on? I missed it. Memory Slam.
I never saw it.
Oh, well, you got that in common with everyone else. OK, and the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown luggage set. I don't understand why he would have that much luggage. All he owns is thongs. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John and Carried, you get the first pick of the letters.
OK, consonant.
Thank you, Carried.
Four consonants.
B. K. N and R.
And then two vowels.
A and E.
And then a vowel and a consonant. Thank you.
I and T.
A consonant, please.
And the last one. M.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. OK, John, how many?
A risky 8.
It's a huge start. OK, carry out.
4.
Risky 4, though, or, you know, solid 4?
Oh, a solid 4.
Solid 4, OK, fine.
Definitely.
Rob, this will make you feel better about the 4.
6.
What?
I knew it.
I think it's real word.
I think it's real word.
Oh, real word. You knew what I meant. Let's not split hairs.
OK.
It's that word, isn't it?
Yeah.
Thank you, Sean.
6 as well.
OK, well, Carrie, let's hear your 4.
Mark.
Mark?
As in Mark something, not the name.
Well, Rob, let's hear your 6.
Banker. Oh.
Banker. Sean, your 6?
Embark.
Embark, OK. And John, your risky 8.
Bite mark.
Bite mark, ah.
Oh, she's gone to the book. This is exciting, isn't it?
and it's not in...
Well, I believe that is 6 points to Sean and Rob. Well, let's go over to the dictionary corner to see if they could have done any better. Jamie, Susie, mainly Susie, could they have done any better?
Brat, that's what I had. That wouldn't be better.
3 7s, I could find Mankia, raiment, as in a garment, and minaret.
OK, on to our first numbers round. OK, Sean and Rob, your turn to pick the numbers.
2 from the top, please, Rachel, and 4 from
Thank
the bottom.
Sean.
Thank you.
Yeah, what he said. Yep. Go for that.
2 big, 4 small.
Good teamwork. Cheers, Sean.
One, another one, 3, 8, and the big ones, 25 and 100. And the target, 984.
OK, and your time starts now. Did you get it?
No, I got 979.
OK. Rob?
Nah, I got to 900 and thought I'm not going to have to do the rest.
John?
I think I might have got it.
OK. Carry out.
Yeah, same as Rob. I got to 900 and I realised that I can't divide, so it's going to be fun.
All right. So, John, how did you do it?
100 plus 25.
125.
Minus 1 minus 1.
123.
Times 8.
Perfect, yeah. 984.
Oh, OK, that's 10 points to John. Can we just get a close-up there of John's most pleased he's ever been face? The scores for the moment, Sean and Rob have 6, John and Carriad have 10. And here is your teaser. The words are wang itch. The clue is... keep your eyes on the ball. That's Wangich, keep your eyes on the ball. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were Wang Itch. The clue was keep your eyes on the ball. It was, of course, watching. So, John and Carriad are in the lead. Time to mix things up a little bit, though, now. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Carriad. So, Carriad, your turn to choose the letters.
Can I have three vowels? Thank you, Carriad. O, A, and E. And four consonants. D, G.
Since I'm not involved in this one, I'm going to pitch 8 out of 10 cats, does Countdown, does Breaking Bad. I don't actually know how you do drugs. I assume you eat it.
Yeah, that's how it ruins your teeth, crystal meth, because you chew it. another consonant. Oh. And a vowel. U. And a consonant, please. And the last one, H.
OK, and your time starts now. What have you got?
I think I've only got five.
That's all right. You're up against Sean. You might do all right. Sean, how many you got?
Six.
Ah! Carrie, what's your five?
Large.
OK. And Sean?
Hurdle.
Well, 6 points to Sean. How's that crystal coming along?
I like it.
Green Moorish, I hear.
Lovely crystal meth. What vintage is that?
It's from the Fox's Glacier Mint.
That's the best house.
Just take a hint of the glue they've used to try and stick it down.
over to Dictionary Corner. Could they have done any better?
So, when Susie got, she said, I had no input, laughed.
You had no input?
Shut up. I know, right.
You're just helping her. You're such a bloody gentleman. So, at the end of that, John and Carriad have 10, Sean and Robert just in the lead with 12. Right now, it's time for John and Rob to go head-to-head. Rob, your turn to pick the numbers.
Two big ones and then all the rest little.
Sounded like you were about to say, and a packet of crisps as well, Rob.
Three, four, and the big one's 175. And the target, 808.
OK, and your time starts now. So the target was 808. Rob, how far away were you?
808.
You got it?
No, that's how far away I was. It's really hard, isn't it?
It really is. John, did you get it?
No, I got 803.
What is the point of you? I mean, Rob's got a life outside of this. This is all you've got, John, and you can't even do this.
I've got a poover.
So how did you get 803?
3 - 1 = 2. × 4 = 8. × 100 = 800.
How have you made your voice more annoying?
And add three.
And add three. The other three. Yep, lovely.
OK, that's 7 points to John.
Does he get the points then?
He gets some points.
Because
yeah.
he's nearest.
But on the letters one, I don't get a point for being near a word. It's either a word or it's a knot.
Oh, it's a knot.
Okay. Rachel, could it be done? And can you tell us how it's done without upsetting them?
There was only a handful I could see.
Only a handful. Sure, take the edge off. Yeah, okay.
If you say 75 times 4 is 300, add 3 for 303, times it by the other 3 for 909, and then take away the 100 and the 1.
OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Jamie, you star in Made in Chelsea, and you are incredibly posh. You make me look like Danny Dyer. We want to find out a bit more about incredibly posh people. Made in Chelsea has its own posh language.
OK.
Rig, what does rig mean?
Well, I think everyone uses rig. Rig is your body, isn't it?
No, everyone uses rig.
No one else uses that?
No.
There are people that are different to you. There's 10 people like you and they're all on your show. No one else has ever used the term rig.
Rig?
Where? If you've never used that, if someone says...
Someone said
rig.
To me, the rig, I thought they were going to the North Sea for oil.
If I said you've got a good rig, you would know what that means,
wouldn't it? He would knock you out, mate.
OK, this is the other thing about posh people. You give kids incredibly bad names. This bit on Made in Chelsea, there's someone called Binky and Phoebe Lettuce Thompson. Why do posh people give their kids such ridiculous names?
Well, they know they'll never need a job.
Good point. It's a very good point.
But I think it's now kind of the fashion to have funny names, isn't it? I got a friend called Horatio.
Mm-hmm.
What, the bloke at JLS?
Horatio in JLS?
Yeah.
Horatio.
Yeah, I don't do H's, do I?
When Rob and Jamie talk, it's like a Dickens novel happening.
How are your shoes doing, sir?
I've got some genuine and made-up posh names here, and they're taken from the birth announcements in the Telegraph. Can you spot which are real and which are fake?
Mm-hmm.
OK? Zebedee Ebenezer J, a brother for Clementine, Florence and Badger. Is that real or did we make it up?
Zebedee, I think that's real.
You're absolutely right, that is a real name.
Oh, yeah. Zebedee. Zebedee's from a magic roundabout. Is it? Yeah, Zebedee is from a magic roundabout.
What my problem with it? What's the badger doing at the end?
What about this one? OK. Electra Esmeralda, a sister for Dorothy, Wolfstein and Cleopatra.
I think that's real as well.
You're absolutely right. That is real. Another real one. Biggles George Fittleworth and Posy Betsy Winifred, a brother and sister for Tuppence.
There was that book, Biggles, wasn't there? So yeah, I think that's real as well.
You're absolutely right. Oh, they're all real. Ladies and gentlemen, Jamie Lang. OK, so Sean and Rob have 12, John and Carriad have 17. Here's your teaser. The words are fart woes. The clue is there's an app for that. That's fart woes. There's an app for that. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were fart woes. The clue was there's an app for that. It was, of course, software. OK, on with the game. Sean and Rob, your turn to choose the letters.
You want to choose, Rob?
Four of the C's.
How lazy are you?
Four C's, four V's, and then...
We'll have a look.
We'll have a look and see where we are.
G. O. E.
God, you've gone for a couple of lively ones, haven't you?
I.
A consonant,
yeah. Yeah. That's what I was thinking, Sean. Thanks.
Last one.
Oh. OK, and your time starts now.
Thank you.
4.
Not great.
No, that'd be 5, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Which I think I could have had.
Sean?
I've only got 5.
OK. John?
I'll try a 6, then.
Carrie-Ann?
I think it's a 5, but it might be wrong.
All right, Rob, what's your 4?
Gear.
Carrie-Ann, what was yours?
Voger, V-O-G-E-R. I feel like it's a maths term, but I might have just made that up.
OK, Sean, you had a 5, I believe?
Yes, very much what everyone, first thing that comes into their mind when they think about me. Giver. In biblical times, there'd be Sean the Giver.
OK, John, you're 6. For the points.
It's what the suffragettes fought for. Voltage.
Voltage?
We just want a bit of voltage, mate. No?
No.
Their battle goes on.
So, Sean, you get 5 points. Susie, Jamie, could they have done any better?
Susie got an 8.
It's a ravigotte. Mixture of chopped chervil, chives, tarragon and shallots used to give piquancy to a sauce or as a base for a herb butter.
Ravigotte. Well, if you got that at home, get out more. The scores at the moment, John and Carrie-Anne have 17, Sean and Rob also have 17. OK. Time to go over once again to Jamie Lang in Dictionary Corner. You're from Chelsea and you're incredibly posh. Rob, you're from Lewisham and you're not.
I thought you'd go scum. You're posh and Rob, you're scum.
I've got the teeth for a posh do.
You have got the teeth of a posh man, yeah.
Yeah, I've got the teeth of a posh man.
Yeah, you should give those back. OK, so we're going to play a quiz to see how much you know about each other's worlds. Yeah. To the podiums.
I'm ready, mate.
I'm ready, mate. Is that
OK. It looks like a demonstration of, yeah, you can dye your hair blonde, but don't get carried away.
Mine's not that bad, is it?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
I know I look like the guy from Back to the Future.
Biff Tannen.
Doc.
It looks like when twins get separated and one is raised rich and one is raised poor.
All right, Rob, you've got questions about Chelsea and posh things, and Jamie, you've got questions about Lewisham and other stuff. Here we go. Yeah, that's where the money goes.
I feel so tense now, didn't it?
OK. Jamie, what does the acronym CHAV stand for?
Acronym. CHAV. It means CHAV... Someone help me out.
It's not an acronym.
It's not an acronym.
It originated from people from Chatham because they used to call them CHAVs. So you're talking out your arse, mate. Sorry, sir.
OK, according to this, it's council housed and violent. CHAV.
That's, you just nicked that from a Plan B song. It don't mean that. It comes from CHAV.
OK, Rob.
Yeah?
What does the posh acronym BYW stand for?
Is it like BYOB?
A little bit.
BYOB?
Bring your own booze.
Bog off?
Boggle?
Bog off.
What is it? It's not bog off, it's...
Buy one, get one free.
Bog off? I swear that I've got myself in a terrible double act.
It's like watching chimps find a mirror.
Have you seen that, though?
What?
They put a mirror in the jungle and the animals saw themselves the first time. It's actually fascinating.
So, BYW.
Bring your wealth. Bring your wellies.
Yes! Rob, take a look at the screen. What is this posh food?
Is it like little eggs? Are they little eggs?
Yeah, what kind of eggs?
Little eggs.
What
you've
kind of
had
eggs,
those
though?
Before, stop lying.
Small eggs.
Yeah, little small eggs. Well, yeah, well, little eggs.
I don't know what more you want from me.
What bird did it come from? What
What bird did it come from?
Yeah.
Little one.
You put, like, you put some salt in it and you have it cold.
Yeah.
In,
like, I know packets. How to eat an egg, yeah.
Like quail's eggs.
Quails? Oh, yeah, that rings a bell.
OK, Jamie, mm-hmm. You're on Lewisham High Street.
Mm-hmm.
It's already a hypothetical. Someone asks you for a cow's calf. What are they after?
Half or something. Is that right?
I mean, you're...
Cow's calf, half a pint.
No, it's 50 pence. OK, Rob, if you meet the Queen, what should you call her?
Your Highness?
You would call Your Majesty Your Highness. You're a disgrace.
To be fair, though, I'd probably get a briefing. I wouldn't just go straight in, balls deep, and out nine...
Oh, I can tell you at the end of that, Rob's won. And here is your final teaser. The words are a rank goo. The clue is commonly found in the bush. That's a rank goo commonly found in the bush. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were a rank goo. The clue was commonly found in the bush. It was, of course, kangaroo. OK, time for our final letters game. John and Carrie, your turn to choose the letters.
We'll have a consonant, please.
Thank you, John. F.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant, please.
P.
Is that a dirty word?
It's an online term for masturbation. Ah.
A vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant, please.
M.
Fathom.
A consonant, please.
S.
A vowel, please.
U.
A consonant, please.
S.
Bathroom seats.
That's what Jamie's going to call his firstborn.
Consonant, please.
The last one.
E. Your 30 seconds starts now. John, how did you do?
A five.
Carrie Ad?
Well, I did really well till I realised that M is not an N. No. So it all went downhill.
Oh, no. What did you think you had?
I thought I had subpoenas.
Subpoenas would have been amazing.
Yeah, I know.
OK, Rob?
I got a six.
Oh.
Yeah. Shut the front door. Sean, how did you get?
Five, Jimmy.
OK, so let's hear your five.
Spams, as in email. Spams.
Yep.
What did you get, John?
Pumps.
OK. Rob, you're six.
Yeah, my six. Mass.
What?
Mass, you know, like little rat thing. M-A-U-S-S-E. Mass. There you go. Pop the E on there. That's it.
Mass. OK, that's 5 points for both teams. Jamie and Susie, could they have done any better? And really, Susie, we're relying on you here because let's face facts.
No, well, actually.
I think I got a seven.
Yeah, the good one.
What?
Oh. Suppums.
It's not in the dictionary, but does it mean what are you having for suppums? Is that the idea?
Yep, that's exactly it.
The only thing I could get was amuses for six.
Amuses for six.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. Still pretty good. OK, so it is neck and neck. John and Carriette have 22, so do Sean and Rob. So it's all to play for. Time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. Your time starts now.
Oh, I've got it.
Go on.
Slapstick.
Let's take a look.
The celebration was poor, but I just got panicked. Two in a row and a conundrum. I'll be on a proper one soon. Oh, I'm a bit worn out now. I'm going to pass out.
That's the adrenaline rush that is pure countdown, mate.
But I've got it.
Oh, you're very good. Well done.
Thanks, Sean.
And you can see I'm just equally as excited as you.
So the final scores are John and Carriott have 22 points, but tonight's winners with 32, Sean and Rob. Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Luggage Set. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Cats are back same time next Friday. Next Friday from 10, the last leg down under, our favourite threesome in Australia for the most extreme road trip of a lifetime. Next tonight, spanking. Fans of the fetish, your potential perfect partner is about to arrive in brand new first dates.